I am brain dead. My words aren't even making sense anymore.
What is his email? Oh my god. Oh my god, what is his email? My eyes... I need to bleach them.
Hey, I'm Jake the Atheist, and welcome to today's video. It's a wild one, honestly. I got a pretty weird email a couple months ago, and I've been holding on to it. For a rainy day? Rain? It's cloudy outside. But I didn't want to write a big script for a video today, okay? I just wanted to do something quick. And I've got two cameras set up this time, so welcome. How's it going? I'm feeling a little bit outnumbered here. But go easy on me, and let's jump into the new intro. Welcome back. How was the intro? Was it cool? Did you like it? Do you want to see it again? Okay, anyway, let's jump into this email, which I've skimmed it before. I haven't honestly read the entire thing, but I got this. Let's see. I got this in the beginning of June. No, beginning of July. I can't read, which is a great thing to have when you're about to read an email. So I got this email about a month ago from anonymousanimportantmessage@gmail.com, which I may have just doxed them right now. I don't know. They have the word anonymous in their name, so they're good, right? They're fine. but the first thing I noticed was that Google or Gmail marked this as spam, and they just put this big ass header at the top, and they said, "This message seems dangerous. Similar messages were used to steal people's personal information. Avoid clicking links, downloading attachments, or replying with personal information." So at first I was like, okay, it's spam, I'm just gonna delete it. But then I caught sight of the subject line, which says, all caps, "God is a God of miracles." And I said, oh, I'm back in. All right, we're gonna hold on to this. So now we are going to take a look at it today, together, as friends. All right, so I'm just gonna read through it. And there are a surprising amount of links embedded in this. And most of them don't seem like spam, they just seem like YouTube links and like random stuff. I haven't even counted how many there are. Just skimming, it looks like there's at least a dozen links to all sorts of strange things. So we're not gonna delve into every single link because that will make this video way too long. But we'll kind of get the gist of what's being said here. And you can help me decide if I should delete this email or if I should print it out and frame it on my wall forever. So yeah, let's start reading. Here we go. "I just feel led to get this off my chest, but I'm here to tell you that judgment is coming very soon upon this world. Please take heed. The world as we know it will very soon be changed forever, and nothing will go back to the way it once was. A mass blackout, massive earthquakes, massive tsunamis, empty shelves in grocery stores, famine and war across the nations will very soon come upon the earth." Dramatic. Okay, there's a YouTube link here. But right after that they say, "Very important. God loves you so much. Please have a watch." Okay, you know what? I'm gonna risk it. I'm gonna click a link, despite Google's warning. We are doing this. Okay, can we do this? Oh, yes, okay. Wait, hold on. Headphone time. All right. Oh, okay. Safety first, kids. And this video's title is called "Jesus is coming soon!" Exclamation point. Parentheses, "Time is short, repent. My son is coming soon, 2021.
Today, 3 years ago at 10 o'clock, God would come to me, and God works in threes all the time. I just had me watching the book of Revelation on the computer, right? And I took my computer from my right to my left, and here it came out of nowhere. It was a father voice. It was booming.
Father voice.
No light. It was nobody. Nobody came to the room.
Whoa! This video is long.
It was like, "You're going to be my messenger."
It's 10 minutes long.
And I said, "What message?" But before I can even get the last.
Okay. To his credit, this guy does look like he just walked out of a Bible story. You know. This like long-ish hair, the beard that's like just all over the place. You know, besides the Patagonia sweater, he could pass for like a Paul or maybe a Peter.
It's a mess. He said, he went boop, and he told me, "Time is short, repent, my son is coming soon."
I'm not going to watch all 10 minutes of this. Maybe we watch it on like twice the speed here. Oh, yeah.
Because before this, before all this for years, real quick, I played pro ball, I was a beast level player, did more drugs in pharmacy, had more sex. And I wailed and wept like a baby. And I was torn. I said, God, here, come back. I said, well, God, if that's all I have, if you sign me up, I'm on a team. What do you want me to do? Fast forward to May 14th, 2000.
I'm just skimming through this video, and it's just like an entirely personal story. I didn't watch a whole lot of that video. It's very long, and we have a lot more to get to. But yeah, my initial thought was it's a personal story from some guy who bragged about how much drugs he had taken in the past and who was now suddenly talking about the voices that he was hearing in his head and how it was God and how he knew things about the future. Okay, video number one, not bad. Let's read on. They say, there will also be major food shortages and empty grocery stores. Major food shortages and empty. Oh, that's a riddle right there. Oh my God. And empty grocery shelves. Oh, I can't even say it. And empty grocery shelves. Shelves. It's because I'm wearing these headphones. I can barely hear myself. And empty grocery shelves. I'm taking these off. There will also be major food shortages and empty grocery shelves coming upon the world due to catastrophic events and the next wave. It's going to get very rough. So please stock up all you can right now. See below for details. I'm glad that they recommend some resources to go to prep before you go to the end of the world. Moving on. The Mark of the Beast will also be implemented very soon, which comes in the form of a small chip the size of a grain of rice. Okay, we're getting a little further into conspiracy territory here. This is
starting to get interesting.
It will be enforced upon the nations and will soon be made mandatory. It will be inserted in the hand or the forehead. Revelation 13:17. And that no man might buy or sell, save that he had the mark, or the name of the beast, or the number of his name. Here is wisdom. Let him that hath understanding count the number of the beast, for it is the number of a man, and his number is 666. Do not take the test swab. It says test swap, but I'm pretty sure they're talking about swab, so I mentally corrected them there. You're welcome. Do not take the test swab, vaccine, or the coming chip. It will change your DNA, and it will make you permanently irredeemable. As somebody who has been tested with a swab, and who has been vaccinated, and who does enjoy several different brands of chips, I can tell you, I don't know what happened to my DNA. I can't find it anywhere. I can't see it with my eyes. It may have disappeared, honestly. He agrees with me. Oh, I feel bad. I feel bad poking fun at this. Like, honestly, this person pretty obviously believes this really sincerely. And, oh man, I feel bad. It's really funny, though. It's kind of funny. Okay, well, they continue. They elaborate on the test swab theories here. They say, the test swab contains nanobot fibers and destroys red blood cells. Do not take it. Here is proof. Oh, okay. Let's check this link out here. Oh, it's a PDF. Oh, man. Time to get some viruses. Analysis of test sticks from surface testing in the Slovak Republic. Confirmation of genocide. Whoa, okay. Keywords: 1. Nylon. 2. DARPA hydrogel. 3. Lithium. 4. Pineal gland. What is this? SD biosensor, Abbott and Natal, in an unnamed hospital laboratory from Bratislava, Slovakia. The test labs were from the sets used in surface testing in Slovakia and in hospitals. Anyone who has at least a standard school microscope and a test microscope can verify the information report regarding the test swabs published here. All information about test swabs, DARPA, hydrogen, lithium is publicly available in scientific and corporate work. From this information, it is clear that test sticks are a criminal tool of genocide in the population of Slovakia. Because we've really got a thing against Slovakia? What the fuck are they talking about? This literally looks like somebody took a picture of a screen, like they don't know how to screen capture something, or like save an image. See this? This is terrible. This quality is garbage. I don't know what's in these pictures. I don't know if it's even what they're describing. From all I know, these pictures could be like taken from anywhere. I know what this is. This is a scope from Call of Duty. Yeah, okay, that makes sense. Let's read this last page here. DARPA hydrogel is an artificial substance that creates a converter between the electromagnetic signal and living cell, tissue, and organ. Converts an electromagnetic signal from a transmitter to a signal which a living cell understands and responds to. See photo of beetle. DARPA hydrogel was injected into the nerve structures and was controllable via radio. What the hell? Okay, this photo, this is amazing. How can anyone not obviously see that this is a dead bug that has already been staged? Look at that, laying on a nice white sheet of paper, its arms all spread out perfectly, evenly symmetrical on each side, the wings are even out. Like, I know what bugs look like when they're mounted, you know? All they did was just pull the needle out and they just turned them into a little robot bug. Yeah, this is hilarious. this is really funny, okay? This is cool. Let's read the rest of this. DARPA hydrogel and lithium block and destroy the pineal gland and cause the thinking person to become a controllable biorobot. Oh my god, this is what's happening, guys. A hydrogel is a carrier of an active substance, and its task is to get the substance into the body at a pre-desired place. Briefly on the issue of vaccines. Vaccines contain DARPA hydrogel. I keep hearing this word. What is DARPA hydrogel? Hello? Lithium and patented genetic information. mRNA is not an untested novelty. In breeding and for top athletes, this type has been using doping for many years. For top athletes, four, this doping significantly shortens the life. Genetic information in the vaccine leads to the creation of a patented mutant. The dream of the dark forces around Bill Gates is to achieve to force these mutants, for example, by vaccination, to regularly upgrade as a computer program. What am I reading? Hello? You saw me reading this. That was not my messing that up. I was reading what was spelled out. This paper is written terribly. We found a gem, ladies and gentlemen. First link that I genuinely enjoyed. This was good. This was relatively convincingly put together at the beginning with the whole, like, progression through these different the photos that they've got going on. I don't understand what these are. Most people probably don't either. So, you know, if they're a little bit more gullible than I was, maybe they would kind of see this as legitimate research. But I think this whole dead bug experiment that they had, and just all the typos, this is not an official document. This was written in somebody's basement, I'm pretty sure. All right, well, that was fun. Let's go back to the email and see what more gems we can find. It looks like they are reaching out to us with the love of God now. Okay, nothing of this world is worth holding on to. No one can save us from what's to come but God. This is a warning of what is to come. Take heed. God loves you so much and wants none to perish. If you are feeling lost, depressed, or suicidal, God is calling you to Him. All it takes is a leap of faith. Oh, there it is.
Ladies and gentlemen, we got him.
Please watch these five videos after you have watched the video link above. Oh my god, this person is giving me homework and I don't even know them. My friends send me YouTube videos and it takes me like a week to watch them. And then all I do is reply LOL and like that's it, okay? This person is clearly reaching with the amount of effort that they think I'm going to go into researching this email from them. And they're completely right, actually. I am going to be doing the research. I will watch all five of these videos. Let's go to the first one.
And hello, everybody, and welcome to the show. That's Satan's bells ringing in the churches today.
Cool.
The blood of Jesus can break all contracts people have made with Satan. Satan will lie and tell you he owns your soul. The truth is, he doesn't own your soul until you are dead. Tonight I want to reach out to all of those involved with black government military projects, the ones who are sitting behind pushing the buttons, the ones involved with psyops and the psychotronics and all of these technologies that make them work.
In the comments, people are just like, please stop sending this into my Discord server. People just use this as spam now. Oh man, lettuce dealer apparently hates his wife. Let's check out the next video.
When he speaks to me, it's not like I hear a voice, but I do get a sensation from the inside out, like there's something, you know, radiating in me.
Yeah.
And I'll think, wow, that had to come from God.
Third link now. Oh, man. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Word from Yahweh. Coronavirus agenda. The kingdom of darkness. Pre-appearing the world for a new world order.
And this is what the Holy Spirit told me.
Just pay attention now.
The virus was released on purpose and everything about it was planned, even down to the citizens taking videos of the truth.
I'm guessing the first place she heard this theory wasn't from God. I'm guessing she had heard this before and she couldn't find any evidence to confirm it. So she just went with how she felt about it, which means God.
The media is saying one thing.
You rascally media. Oh, you. You're just telling your lies.
Like the Bible tells us, they're ever learning but they're unable to come to the knowledge of the truth. And who is the truth? Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. So there's that group.
So there's that. Ooh, this one looks promising. BibleCodesRevealed.com. Okay, is this a blog article? Listen to what God's prophet on earth has to reveal. Okay, is this a podcast or something? Okay, I'm not going to listen to this whole podcast, and I'm not going to read through this entire post. Oh my God. But let's get through some of the headlines, and let's see what this is about. They have several arrival times throughout the year, and the week of December 25th is their next one. Who? Arrival times? Who? Who is this? Well, let's just see if it answers it later on. Our Oregon war against them is accelerating their arrival timetable, so they're going to have to pull off their project Blue Beam, the event, charade, or something. I can't even understand this. What? Wait, we've crashed over 11,000 of their ships from the skies since 2004. What? And what it does is it melts alien technology. What? What? I thought we were talking about coronavirus. Now we're talking about aliens? The Bible says the sun, moon, and stars withhold their shining, and there was a plot to blow up Jupiter and also to blow up the sun. What? 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 They say there's a central sun in the Sagittarius constellation that they're going to blow up, but they're only warning their people that banks might close up to 30 days. What the fuck? Who is they that's saying this? Obama wants to take down the electrical grid because he wants to stay in office. Okay, well, it's a little late for that. Obama's older daughter's on MTV. In women's sports, especially the Olympics, a lot of those women aren't even women. Are they really doing this right now? Are they really saying this shit? Now it's coming out that all of our first ladies have been transgenders. What the fuck is this? What the fuck is this? What the hell? They're throwing so much shit out of left field. What? What's going on? The churches worship two different saviors. Yahushua, Ben David, the real Jesus of the Bible, and Jesus Christ, the fake Jesus. Check your Jesus, ladies and gentlemen. Make sure it's the right one. The Age of Aquarius is the eighth and final regime, which springs out of the New World Order's seventh regime that will usher in the tribulation period. Okay, gotcha. So November 9th, 2016. Ladies and gentlemen, we are in the tribulation period now.
Keep an eye out for flying locusts with the face of men and the tails of scorpions.
The Oregon warriors caused them to delay their plan of blowing up Hoover Dam. Now anything coming through the portal there will get burned and fry. Portal? They had plans to blow up the city of Phoenix. Okay. On the New Age boards, they're talking about the bankers and New World Order people being arrested. Cool. Ann Romney and Oprah Winfrey are involved with the Child Snuff Film Network along with John Kerry. Jesus, can I put this on YouTube still? Hey, here's one that I recognize. Comet Pizza in Washington, D.C. has a concrete torture room with a Tori Smith, a clone, spent a couple years warning and talking about the child trafficking network in this country until Mike Pence had him killed. Oh, Mike Pence is on this, ladies and gentlemen. I now understand. Words fail me right now. Tori Smith was doing everything he could to expose Mike Pence and the government of Indiana. Indiana goes deep, ladies and gentlemen. China, who owns America, handpicked Paul Ryan and General Dunford to emerge as our new president and vice president of the coming new restored Republic of America. They have built a new United Nations building in Kazakhstan so they can just leave New York, blow up D.C., and control the USA from
Kazakhstan.
Donald Trump will hand the power and control of the USA over to the UN, which will make the UN leader the leader of Last Days Babylon and the Antichrist of prophecy. Go to sherrystreiner.com and support our resistance and our Oregon war against the aliens, demons, and scumbags on this earth. Wow. I know a couple scumbags, honestly. Wow. I did not know that they're on the same level as aliens and demons. I will take those a lot more seriously in the future. Damn. I feel like I just got just we were sent through the ringer, the conspiracy theory ringer. That was a gem. Maybe I'll link this and you guys can look at this in the comments. All right, two links left and we're getting to the bottom of the list here. Vatican whistleblower. Satan literally lives inside the Vatican. Part 2.
Particularly because it's the most abominable place on the planet. I went and got some pictures for you. There you go. Look. There is the Basilica, St. Peter's Square. I don't know why they call it a square when it's a circle. There it is. Big old circle with the shaft right in the center of it. Big old penis
They said the word.
Lucifer's penis. They love having that all over the place.
What the fuck?
Underneath Vatican City was a 13-level deep underground alien base. What I call a duab. A deep underground alien base.
Wow, okay. So we're doing a little deep dive into the Vatican. Let's look at the some of this little advertisement here. We've got the Earth cracked into sections here. It says Alien Nation across the top with a little dude poking his head out of the White House here. Got a verse from Daniel. They shall mingle themselves with the seed of men, which I guess they're assuming is like alien infiltration. Here we go. Warning, this site contains an excess of free speech. However, those who matter don't mind, and those who mind don't matter. I like the inspirational quote at the end, but I don't see how that has to do with this website. There's a great comment underneath this video from Boo Boo Kitty, who asks, how do you know all of this? Honestly, I'm going to upvote that because I agree. I'd like to ask the same thing. I'm curious. This is wild. All right. That's enough of that. All right, we're finally at the last paragraph of this surprisingly dense email. It's not very long, but there are rabbit trails galore. I also want to point out aliens are demons. Do not believe the false flag alien invasion NASA will pull off when one of the raptures happen. Starlink and Project Bluebeam will be used for the false alien invasion, which is holographic. Do not believe the lies. This will be a worldwide event. Proof of testing it out. Oh, okay. I appreciate the proof. They've got their sources here. YouTube.com and YouTube.com. Okay, gotcha. I like how they emphasize the L-I-E in the word alien at the beginning here. Like they're pointing out something interesting about the way we spell our words. It's proof. All right, let's check out this link. This is kind of spooky. I hear like storm warnings and flashing lights. What was this supposed to be proof of? Proof of testing out the false holographic alien invasion. Unknown event in Kazakhstan.
Kazakhstan!
Okay. I mean, well, at least they admit that it's unknown. But then they just go right into assuming, oh, this is what it is. It's unknown, but it's this. It's this, of course. But like, why would they have their sirens going off and like warning people about whatever's happening here? Like, unless it was maybe some sort of military thing. I don't know. There's technology all the time being developed. But there's a lot of explanations before we jump into aliens are demons and they're going to invade the world and take over your brain and control you like the little bug man. Let's check out the second video, though. We'll see if there's a little bit more evidence. Okay, oh my god. Wake up the entire world. I need answers ASAP. 2021 is starting off with an alien invasion? Hello? Okay, looking at this, I've done visual effects like this before. I know how to like create particles and like add laser beams and make portal effects and explosions and stuff like that. And this could very easily be CGI. Honestly, if this was filmed on a phone and that beam is as bright as it looks on the frame, the rest of the frame here would be completely dark because the dynamic range of most camera sensors would not be able to handle the difference in light between the very dark edges and shadows of these buildings and trees and this pure bright blue radiating light that's coming from the sky. You would either see like the houses kind of roughly exposed and just the white would be completely gone. Like the entire sky would just be like lit to all hell. Or the beam would kind of be roughly exposed, but everything around it that was darker would just be plunged into shadow because the camera is trying so hard to like expose this white area. Like the exposure of this is seriously doubtful to me. Like look at these houses here reacting to the light. I'll kind of like mute and just play through it while I talk. But you can see that like when the light is hitting them, it's just kind of this entire area is being lit, just like one big glow. And it doesn't matter which part of the house it is, the entire house is just being lit up. Like You don't see any harsh shadows coming out from this light. You don't see like the roofs of the houses being lit as opposed to like the backside staying dark. Like, this is obviously an artificial light source and it's pretty easy to see through. I mean, this looks like it's a densely populated area, and this probably would have made the news if something like this had happened. And I don't know what in the world is hitting the ground here, but it probably left some damage. If it's some sort of shockwave pull, whatever, alien attack thing. But yeah, none of this has been reported besides this one video, which lends itself to the probability that it's faked, and which is my conclusion as well. The comments here, I think, agree with me. Although I don't know if I have quite enough information to make a judgment as to this video's sexual orientation, but I do agree that it is fake. So that's that. Sorry if there's a little bit more background noise. My camera over here kept shutting off, so I had to switch on my AC unit over there. Hopefully this mic isn't picking up too much of that, but if you hear a little bit of that, that's why. I'm trying to make a video and not break my gear. Let's take a look at the last paragraph here. I think there's one more link before we're done. It's been a ride. And we're not going to delve into every single link because that will make this video way too long. Maybe we'll finish with a nice finale here. Maybe it'll fizzle out and burn, but we shall see. Video unavailable. Okay. Okay. Okay, guys. Dead end here. I think it fizzled out. That was a wild ride. I have no idea what to think. This is crazy. This is insane. Oh my god. My eyes. I need to bleach them. What is this email? Oh my god. Oh my god. What is this email? I've been recording for like 2.5 hours. Just skimming through all of this stuff. And you're welcome for cutting it down to however long this video is now. But I am brain dead. My words aren't even making sense anymore. Do I have thoughts? Do I have thoughts anymore? Am I, what the hell? God, that was so much stupid in one video. I don't like to make fun of people or their ideas all that often, but this is just insane. Like, from the bug, the chip on the bug that was like obviously fake, to the CGI video later on, this is just, oh man, I feel bad for the person who sent this, honestly. Like, not in like a condescending way, like, I genuinely want to know what convinced them of this kind of stuff to begin with. Like, should I reply? Have you guys gotten any messages like this before? Because I haven't, and I've never seen a spam message like this, so maybe it's from an actual person? I don't know. I'm dead. I am beat. I don't even know what to think about this video anymore. I don't believe any of it. Let's be clear on that, okay? But yeah, let me know what you think of some of these things. I had to skim pretty fast through this just to cover it in one decent length video. I hesitate to say send me more emails like this, but maybe send me more emails like this? I've heard a couple of these conspiracy theories before, but I've never heard so many all at once. Let's just say that. All I've had as far as sustenance has been an energy drink for the past like 4 hours. So it's probably just accelerating my decline. Oh God, this video killed me. If you're still here, why? But also thank you for watching. Thank you very much for putting up with this. It was interesting. I'm not like a science expert or a medical expert or a politics expert. But it was fun trying to kind of like piece my way through these, and I didn't understand a couple of them, so I'll leave those for smarter, more scientifically minded people than me. But yeah, this was a, I was gonna say a bucket of crazy, but no, this was like a truckload of crazy. I don't know how to end this video anymore. Like, I thank you for watching. Please subscribe. Please, I did this for you. Please do something for me. Click the little button. I think it's right there. Is it that one? Yeah, I hope this was interesting. I hope this was entertaining. And I hope, please, with all of my being, I hope that none of you believe the same stuff that this person does. Because as my Gmail says, this message seems dangerous. It's probably the best place to end it. So thanks for watching. Check me out on socials. Watch me game on Twitch. And
Oh my god. I've been Jake the Atheist. I'm so sorry. Please, please do something more productive with the rest of your day. I'll see you in the next one. We'll get him next time. Ugh. Ugh.